All right, guys, so we know we are literally about to enter a massive bull run. This is a very, very huge moment right now for Bitcoin and crypto. I truly do hope you guys are truly prepared, okay? Because I know, guys, okay, we did go through one of the longest bear markets ever, okay? 2022, I don't know if you guys remember, 2022 was honestly one of the worst ever times for Bitcoin and crypto, right? A lot of negative things around the crypto space did in fact happen, right? Which caused Bitcoin and crypto to drop even more. And I will talk more about that throughout today's video, because there is in fact one specific chart that I do want to show you guys towards the end of this video. So today I do want to do the usual, give you guys some Bitcoin charts. Why? Okay, we should be very, very bullish right now, even though, yes, so far it's not a great start for this month of October. And we know, guys, October is one of the most bullish times, okay, and months for Bitcoin and crypto, right? But understand, okay, this is completely normal. Just like last year in 2023, October, we didn't see, a great start for that time, right? In October of 2023. Same is what's happening for this year, 2024. History is repeating itself. And there is, in fact, a chart that I want to show you guys. But before I show you guys these charts, I want to give you guys an update on what is happening with Bitcoin and crypto today. So Bitcoin starting off 62, okay, $62,700. Okay, so Bitcoin right now is slightly bouncing back up. Okay, a couple of hours ago, we actually saw Bitcoin up almost $63,000. Okay, 62.9K. And it seems like right now, if we go to the 15-minute mark, time frame right here, Yashin's clear to see, it is bouncing. Okay, so Bitcoin is still pretty much holding strong at this 62K level, just like where we saw it yesterday. Same with Ethereum, $24,000. Solana still below 150, okay. Chainlink, still holding at $11. So we're not seeing huge, huge movements today for the crypto market, right? We are in fact seeing slight movements, but nothing too crazy. Past 24 hours, both Bitcoin and Ethereum are both up 1%. Same with BNB. Solana is up over 2%. Great to see for Solana. Dogecoin 2%. Okay, Toncoin, almost 2% as well. Cardano 2%, Avalanche 5%. Great to see for AVAX, right? 5% today. Same with Shiba Inu. Okay, looking pretty good. So some alts are in fact moving. Look at Sui, 5%. Okay, this altcoin 9%. So yeah, past 24 hours, okay, a fair few alts are pumping. Look at Dog with Hat, 14% today, up over 10%. Okay, but it is at $2 right now. Like, I remember seeing this coin at like $5 last, like a couple months back. So it is down a fair bit. But yeah, fair few alts today are in fact moving. At least today, yesterday we didn't really see huge, huge movements. But today, Bitcoin and other alts are slightly moving up to the upside, which is great to see. Okay, but nothing too crazy. Now, El Salvador is buying more Bitcoin, right? So El Salvador are in fact buying more Bitcoin today. Okay, and I hope you guys, okay, us retail investors are in fact buying a whole bunch of Bitcoin as well, because we know, guys, okay, a lot of institutions out there, like for example, BlackRock, they are in fact accumulating a whole bunch of Bitcoin, right? And I told you guys, you don't want to sell your Bitcoins, because when you sell your Bitcoins, a lot of these institutions, like for example, BlackRock, will buy your Bitcoins. They want your Bitcoins. They want to take your Bitcoins. They know where Bitcoin is heading long term, right? So, guys, I repeat, do not sell your Bitcoins. Okay, don't sell it. Okay, if you want to take some profits right in the next upcoming bull run, I get it, right? Go ahead, but don't sell all your Bitcoins, right? For altcoins, that's fine. Go ahead and take as much as you possibly want. But with Bitcoin, guys, okay, don't sell all your Bitcoins. Keep some of your Bitcoins for long term. We know where Bitcoin is heading long term, right? So that's that. Okay, not financial advice. Always do your own research. Okay, so yeah, El Salvador is buying. Okay, even whales, right? I talked about this a couple of videos back. Okay, new whales are in fact buying a whole bunch of Bitcoin, right? We know BlackRock, okay, for example, they are buying a whole bunch of Bitcoin. Okay, a lot of these institutions, like I said, they are in fact stacking as much Bitcoin as they possibly can. Okay, so y'all just clearly see, okay, new whales are buying Bitcoin like crazy. Same, they did in 2020 before the explosive run up. Okay, so they know, guys, that we are in fact about to enter a bull run. They are completely stacking right now. They are buying as much as they possibly can. And like I said, us retail investors, we should be doing the exact same thing. Okay, what these whales are doing, we should be buying as well. You know, to truly prepare ourselves to, you know, get ready for the next upcoming bull run. If you simply want to, you know, make money in this market, right, and of course build wealth, okay, you got to buy now. You got to take action, guys. You got to be in the game, right? So I hope you guys watching this video right now are in fact buying as much Bitcoins or your favorite altcoins as much as you possibly can right now, because understand a massive bull run is coming. Time is ticking. We don't have a lot of time left. Okay, so I hope you guys are in fact stacking as much as you possibly can. So this is the chart that I wanted to show you guys, and I've talked about this a fair few times now for my past few videos for the past few days, but you guys can clearly see it says here Bitcoin dropped 7% in the beginning of October 2023. This time it dropped about the same. Do you remember what happened next? So you guys can clearly see if we look back in 2023, October, right? October 2023, we did actually see Bitcoin dropping, right? Early of that month last year, okay, we saw Bitcoin dropping, right? It wasn't a great start for October for 2023. Was not a great start. But then, right, we saw it pumping, okay? The next few weeks, it started to pump up to the upside, right? And, you know, we saw Bitcoin up over 28%, almost 30% in October 2023, which was absolutely amazing. Right, same with what's happening right now this time around. Okay, not a great start right now for Bitcoin. Bitcoin is down what, like 3%, 4% right now. Okay, I think it's around 3%, actually, not 4%. It's not a great start, right? Today is the 7th of October. Okay, we are literally a week in. We have 3 weeks left, guys, into this month. I still believe October, okay. October and Pumptober, whatever you want to call it. A lot of people call it October. It's still on track, right? It's still gonna happen. So I really do believe, okay, next upcoming few weeks will be amazing for Bitcoin. I do see Bitcoin reaching at least above $70,000, potentially even reaching back up to its previous highs above $73,000, even reaching a new high. I think that is very, very possible in the next upcoming few weeks. So if you guys really, really think about it, we don't have a lot of time left to buy Bitcoin at, you know, 62K, because Bitcoin has been consolidating in between 60k and like 69k for the past like few weeks and few months, right? So we don't have a lot of time left, guys. Soon enough, Bitcoin will be reaching a new high. Mark my words on that, right? When we end off this year in October, Bitcoin will for sure 100% be above $70,000. That's just personally my opinion, and I'm pretty sure you guys can agree with me on that one, right? So guys, get ready, okay? Not a great start for this month, but understand, okay, we have seen this before, just like last year. October 2023 wasn't a great start, but then, you know, the remaining few weeks, it started to pump. Same thing is pretty much going to happen for this time around, for this year, 2024 of October. So Bitcoin holders, get ready for the next upcoming few weeks. And this is coming up, guys, right? So Bitcoin is coming up on one of its most bullish times, the US election. And I told you guys this many times, it doesn't matter who wins this election. Either it's Kamala Harris or Donald Trump. Right, either way, Bitcoin is gonna enter a bull run and enter the next bull market. Right, it doesn't matter who wins. Obviously, if Donald Trump wins, it'll be a bit more bullish, right? Like a bit more better. I should say bullish, but a bit more like better for Bitcoin and crypto, right? But either way, it doesn't really matter who wins here, guys, because every single time, okay, after we have a US election or after it, we always see Bitcoin pumping every single time, pretty much in a halving year. 2012, okay, back 2012, we had the US election, Bitcoin pumped. Same with 2016, okay, right after the US election, it pumped. Same with 2020, okay, our most recent US election, right after it, Bitcoin pumped. This time around, I don't see why it will be any different, right? It's going to be the exact same thing, right? And I just want to show you guys this, okay, because it just clearly shows us here, okay, 29 days before the US election. Okay, we are almost there, guys. Okay, we have the halving. Okay, and this just clearly shows you guys, you know, every single time we have a Bitcoin halving event, we don't see Bitcoin pumping straight away. And this chart obviously shows you guys that, right? You have to see 2016, it was stagnant, right? We didn't see huge, huge movements after the Bitcoin halving event, right? Same with 2020, right? Really, really stagnant. Same with what's happening right now, right? It's been a few months now, we know that. So after the US election, that's when Bitcoin pumps, okay? And this is in these halving years, 2016, 2020, and 2024, even in 2012. So you have to just clearly see, as I told you guys, it's all about patience, right? We just have to, you know, be very, very patient. And obviously during this time when it was consolidating, would have been the best time to buy, right? To simply DCA and hold, most importantly, right? So I hope you guys have in fact been buying and DCAing, okay? Because soon enough, we're gonna see a run up, okay? Very, very soon. And you guys just clearly see we're not too far off from US election, okay? So get ready for that. Now this is the last chart that I want to show you guys. It says here Q4 2024 will be the beginning of Bitcoin mega bull. Bitcoin run will continue until at least Q4 2025, and I think that's very, very possible. You know, towards the year 2025, I think that's when the bull market's gonna end, okay? And then of course we're gonna enter, you know, next year 2026, and then of course it's going to drop, right? Because that's when we will enter the next bear cycle. Remember, guys, we always enter different cycles, a bull cycle and a bear cycle, right? So 2014, okay, was not a great year. It dropped, but then 2015, 2016, and 2017, especially 2017, it started to pump. Same with 2018, right? It dropped again. Okay, we enter the next bear cycle. And then 2019, all right, 2020, and of course 2021, okay, it started to pump. 2022, right, we know, guys, was one of the worst times ever for Bitcoin and crypto, right? That year was terrible, right? We were already in a bear market, and a lot of crypto exchanges started shutting down, like for example the biggest one, FTX, and that obviously caused the market to drop even more. And of course other things, like negative things like Terra Luna happening, obviously we saw Terra Luna collapsing, and that obviously caused Bitcoin to drop even more, even altcoins. The entire crypto market just collapsed like crazy, right? So 2022 honestly was one of the worst times for Bitcoin and crypto, in my opinion, right? I experienced it. I don't know if you guys have experienced it, but honestly, it's one of the worst times. And I always tell you guys this, but if you simply survived 2022, like literally, if you survived that year, 2022, you can literally survive anything in the crypto space, literally anything, because 2022 was one of the worst times ever, right? But anyways, and then 2023, 2024, and of course, next year, 2025 will be amazing, right? So get ready, guys, for the year 2025, okay? Get ready for 2025, because just like we saw back, 2021, 2017, even back in 2013, we know 2013 was a fantastic year for Bitcoin and crypto. It's going to be the same thing for 2025, right? The exact same thing. 2025 will be a epic year, okay? Because that's when we will obviously be in a bull run, and of course most importantly be in a bull market. So I hope you guys are truly ready for next year 2025, because Bitcoin will be at a new high, Ethereum will be at a new high, most likely Solana will also be at a new high, Chainlink, you guys know I'm a huge fan of Chainlink. And I do believe Chainlink is going to be at a new high. And a lot of these altcoins will potentially be at a new all-time high as well. So get ready for that, you guys. Okay, Bitcoin's going to skyrocket when alt season is right around the corner. We know meme season also, right? We can't forget about meme coins. Meme season is also right around the corner. So I hope you guys are ready for next year, 2025, because it's going to be a great year for crypto. Okay, a very, very huge moment is happening right now, guys. Like literally. Right, so if you want to simply be in this market to experience a massive bull market, right, experience massive gains in your portfolio, you better get in now. You better take action now. You better buy as much as you possibly now, right? So that's that, guys. Okay, this is a huge moment right now for Bitcoin and crypto. Okay, we are literally at the home stretch right now before us seeing, you know, a massive run up, a massive parabolic movement. So I hope you guys are truly ready for that. But guys, I'm gonna go ahead and end today's video. Hope you guys all enjoyed. It seems like Bitcoin right now is pumping. Okay, we'll see if it will bounce back up to at least $63,000. Right now it's at $62,800. So Bitcoin is pumping, and we'll see tomorrow, okay, if it will pump back up above $63,000. We will see, but I will obviously, you know, keep you guys updated on that. But guys, I'm gonna go ahead and end today's video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Give a thumbs up and of course subscribe to the channel. That is always appreciated. And I catch you guys all in my next video. Have a good one, guys.